So guys, in this video, we will see how to upload a file automatically in Python automation, right? So for that, we obviously need the path of the file. So for example, we have this image over here, right? So let's open it. Okay, this is a really big image, I guess. Yeah. So you can see this is the image which we have, and this is really big image actually. Anyways, this is the image, okay, which we will send through automation. And in our previous videos, we use this test and then a constant message, right? You can obviously use the input method to ask the user whatever message he wanna send and whatever person he wanna send, right? That is not a big deal, by the way. And now we will send photos or videos, okay? So let me just set one more thing over here, a file path, where the path of the actual photo or video will be saved. So I'll just write file underscore path, and that will be equals to input, enter the file path. Okay, that's fine. And I can also use this message also as a custom message. So I'll just write over here input, enter the message. You can also write input over here so that he will ask whom it is going to send the message, but for now it is test, obviously, because we will send all the message to the test account. So that's why. Anyway, so let's close this one and run it again. Fine, it is now opening in the Chrome automated version, and now here we have to scan the barcode or QR code. Yeah, fine, scan successfully, and now it will open. You can clearly see it is asking me enter the file path, right? So we actually need to put the path over here. So the image name is let me just copy it over here, copy the file path, paste it over here, and let me remove this one and use forward slash, because you already saw it uses the forward slash, not the backslash. So anyways, I'll just write forward slash, and there is one more thing, we have to write the file name. So it is actually image.jpg. I'll just copy the name and paste it over here, .jpg, and enter the message, right? So testing Python automation. Fine, let's run it. That's perfect, it ran properly. And if I run it, obviously it will send all the messages to the test target. By the way, we also want to upload the file. So for that, obviously we need the ID or class, whatever there is. So we will just maximize this screen, and let's open test manually. And here I'll just right click on it and click on inspect. Okay. And you can clearly see, let me just click on this mouse option and go over here. Yeah. So it is actually under this div class. Okay. It has a class name and it is under the div tag. Okay. And inside this div tag, we have another div class, okay, div tag, and it has a title attach. So let me click on it, and you can see it is actually that section, that attachment section, right? So we have to click on this attachment section. So let me minimize that screen, and let's write over here attachment section. Okay, you can write whatever you want over here, and that will be nothing but, sorry for the message, and that will be nothing but the browser dot find element by xpath. We have to write the path like this, okay, forward slash pan, but here it is actually div. So let me see that again. Yeah, it is actually div, and the title is attach, right? So we have to write like this, a parenthesis, then inverted comma, forward slash div, because it is now div, not a span, and then a box bracket, at the rate title is nothing but equals to attach. Fine, now we have to click on that, right? So we will just write over here attachment section dot click. Okay, and after clicking on that, we will get these four sections, like photos and videos, camera, document, and contact. We will use only the first option, photos and videos. So let's see the ID of that. Okay, so I'll just click on this mouse option and go over here, and So actually, the image section is an input tag. Okay, so this is the section which is take which has a option accept, right? Accept this whole thing. So we are going to use that thing. So let me just write over here, image. Okay, yeah, image underscore box, and that is equals to browser dot find underscore element by XPath. This one, and it will take. The tag is input, I guess. Yeah, you can see it is an input tag. So we have to write over here forward slash then input, and then a box bracket, and here we will just write accept. Let me go over here again and copy this thing from accept to the whole thing. Okay, till time, and now minimize this thing and write it over here. Yeah, fine. Okay, so you can clearly see that it is actually an input tag which takes this argument, whatever you can say, and now we have to send the file path over there, right? Because if you click on it, it will ask for the file path. So we have to send the file path over this section, right? Image box. So we will write over here image underscore box, and that is going to be send underscore keys, and path is file underscore path, right? Great. Now we have to send that photo, right? So let me choose that file path over here. So it is under the tutorial folder, WhatsApp automation, and this image actually. Okay, so let's open it. Now you can see we have this send button over here, right? So we have to find the ID or class of this button, right? So let's maximize it again and click on this mouse and go into this section, right? So you can see this button is under this div option, div tag, and you can see this is, there is an arrow, right? So we have to go more inside of it. So let's go inside it, and okay, and you can see there is a span tag over here, right? And the argument is data icon, that is equals to send light, right? So we have to write it over here again. So let's write over here send button, and that is equals to browser dot find element by XPath again, because we don't have any ID or class name over here, right? So we have to using this XPath anyway. So let's write the path, and that is actually a span tag. So let's go over there. Yeah, you can see it is a span tag, so we have to write over here span, like we already did over here, span then title and all. Anyways, so span, and that will be I guess a data type. So I'll just copy it from here, data type, the whole thing, fine, and paste it over here. Great. And now we have to click on this option to send the picture, right? So we have to write send underscore button dot click. Okay, but there is one more thing over here. Let me close this one. And now if you go and choose the file and click on open, it takes some time to load that photo or video, whatever that is, right? So we imported the time already, so we have to use the time to wait for few seconds, so that it should not click on the send button instantly. It should wait for 2 or 3 seconds, then click on the send button, right? Otherwise it will not load the picture or video and it will send nothing. So we will just need to write over here sleep for around 2 seconds or 3 seconds. 3 seconds would be perfect, I guess. Yeah, so now let's see whether it is working or not. So let me close this one, and first of all let's see the above one. Okay, let's see that it should send the message. What is the message? Actually the message is testing Python automation for 50 times, right? So let's click enter over here, and you can see it is working fine, testing Python automation for 50 times in around I guess 600 milliseconds. Yeah, it is working fine. And now let's see whether it works or not. It let me send all the messages over here. Yeah, it sent all the messages. Now let's see whether it choose the file and send it automatically or not. So let's run it. Okay, there is a syntax error. Well, yeah, we have to write like this, because for simplification we use that method, but we have to write like this anyway. So let's run it. There is a wave driver exception. Let's see what is the error. Unknown path. Okay, so the path is unknown, right? So we have to choose the path more carefully. Actually, I need to write C, then clone, then forward slash. That's why it is showing this error. So okay, let me just run the first cell again. So let me close this one and run the first cell again. Now you can see it opened the WhatsApp web, and now we have to scan the QR code. Okay, so now we have to enter the file path, right? So let me go over here. WhatsApp automation, just click on it, copy the names, copy the file path actually, and I need to change the backslash with forward slash. This is really a hectic one. Fine, and now we have to write the file name, that is image.jpg. I guess, yeah, that's right. And now let's enter and send a message, for example, automated anything. So now let's run it. Okay, let's run the second cell. You can see it is working fine. There is an error. Oh, okay, actually that is for the last cell. We have to run that cell again, so to send the photo. So let's run it. Okay, before that, actually this sleep 3 will throw an error because we didn't import sleep, right? So from time we have to import the sleep anyway. So let's make it a comment and run it again. Okay, there is an error. Okay, let's make the sleep time so that it should not make any error, and let's write over here from time import sleep. Okay, now let's run it. Well, yeah, now you can see that it sent the photo automatically. So let's do it again with another photo. Let me download a photo over here. Let me go into Unsplash and go into the animals section, and there let me choose this one. Okay, this looks good, so let's download it and write the name image 2. Okay, fine. So let's close this one, and actually instead of writing the file path again, we can just copy this one, copy the path, and let's make another section over here, cell, and here I'll just write file_path, and that is equals to this one, and the name is image2.jpg. fine, now let's run it and run this cell. Okay, there is an error. Again a wrong word. Let's see over here. Okay, there is a long extension .cr download, whatever that is. So instead of choosing that file, let me copy one more photo from my photos images. I can copy this photo. Okay, and let's go over there and paste it as boy.jpg. okay, that's fine. So let's write over here, file path is boy.jpg. fine, and now let's run that final cell. It's working. Yeah, it sent properly. So in this way you can send photos or videos using the Selenium, and you can automate the whole WhatsApp, right? And you can obviously ask for the path, the message, the user which you wanna send, and all using the input tag, input method. Okay, so this is the actual code. You can see that code, and this is also available in my GitHub profile. You can go in my GitHub profile, and from there you can download these files as well. Okay.